Hi, when it comes to resolution of a machine vision system, you probably are thinking of the camera resolution. But you do know that an equally important parameter is the optical resolution. Hi, my name is Raghava Kashyapa. I'm the CEO of Qualitas Technologies. And in this video, I'm going to explain to you another aspect of resolution, which is the lens resolution of a machine vision system. So, the resolution is oftentimes confused with just the camera resolution. How many pixels does it have? So you've heard terms which is 1.3 megapixel or 5 megapixels, and even some of the latest cameras which have up to 100 megapixel. But in order to be able to take advantage of these very large resolutions of cameras, the optical system also needs to be equally compatible with that resolution. So let me explain. So when you talk about resolution, it's really the sensor of the camera which is subdivided into tiny pixels on the sensor area. And the more number of pixels you're packing into a fixed area of the sensor, the tinier each pixel becomes. Now, in order to actually get that level of detail, the optical system has to ensure that the light rays that are hitting these tiny pixels are exactly being focused on the right areas. So let's take a very simple example. So let's say you have two different lines and you want to see the distinction or the gap between the two lines. So you want to make sure that there is at least one pixel gap between the two black pixels, which is the white pixel. So if you don't have that white pixel, then it pretty much looks like one big black pixel. And if, for instance, the optical system was not capable enough of resolving at such a granularity, then what would happen is there would be overlapping of these light rays, making the two lines very indistinguishable, or the gaps between the two lines indistinguishable. And that's where the lens resolution comes in. And lens resolution is defined by the line pair per mm. In other words, how many lines can you actually image very clearly by being able to distinguish these lines with a gap. Because the more number of lines you have, the gap becomes smaller, making the demand on the optical resolution much higher. So when you calculate the lines pair per mm, it actually goes back to how small the pixel area is for a given camera. The smaller the given pixel size, the higher the lines pair per mm needs to be in order to match that tiny pixel. But the bigger it is, you have more relaxation when it comes to the optical resolution. And as you've guessed, high resolution lenses are more expensive, and sometimes they're much more expensive than the camera itself. So the next time you go out and purchase or use a very high resolution camera, you might be misled into believing that you're building a very accurate system if you don't match the appropriate lens to that camera size. Hope this video is useful. For more such tips, do check out our video channels on YouTube as well as on our homepage. Thanks and have a great day.